Hey, good afternoon, guys. This is Matt Rivers, and I wanted to talk to you about a Wall Street Journal article I read this morning. And don't laugh, I actually I don't read the Wall Street Journal, but for some reason this ad, you know, this article stuck out because it had Facebook on it, so I read it. And there's a real issue happening in Facebook. Not that they're not making too much money, but the issue is that they may be getting too big to even police themselves. You know, there's a lot of advertisers that they're just, you know, collecting money from to allow them to, you know, send apps, you know, advertise on Facebook. But the challenge is some of these apps are not for kids, you know. So what happens is inadvertently kids get drawn into it. You know, the marketing is actually targeted to teens, you know, the younger crowd. But, you know, when 14-year-olds and stuff like that start getting looked up by, you know, grown adult men, you know, thinking something different, and the 14-year-old has no idea that, you know, their face is plastered all over these particular apps, because it's some type of app where you can say yes, you would date this person or not. You know, I guess, are they hot or not? And you know, and innocent, you know, young kids are kind of getting, you know, drawn into it unbeknownst to them. So what happens is these adults are actually going to the profiles of these kids, because I guess, you know, because of the crowds are so young, they're saying, yeah, I would date this person. You know, it might be a young, you know, kid, you know, 10, 14, whatever. And then these adult men go scrounging around, looking around for more information on that particular person, because, you know, they're perverts or whatever. So I don't know. It's an issue. I'm not sure it's totally Facebook's fault. But then again, they should have some kind of fail-safes in place that won't allow this to happen in the future. So I don't know. I welcome your comments, guys. Let me know what you think. Talk to you later. Peace.